with Tommy Dreamer forgiven by an AEW star, and Gable Steveson said to have a better personality than Kurt Angle. This is Wrestling Hub. My name is John, and you're watching the Wrestling Report for September 20th. Before we get into the rest of the video, make sure you subscribe to Wrestling Hub and turn on all notifications to stay up to date with everything in the world of pro wrestling. Many are aware of the backstage hazing that happened in the world of pro wrestling, and on that 90s wrestling podcast, former WWE star Rene Dupree shared his experiences when it came to being the victim of bullying. As he revealed, The Undertaker orchestrated something pretty disrespectful. They took my $500 shoes and a $1,000 suit and ruined it in the shower because I didn't go out drinking at a bar the night before because nobody invited me. That's just materialistic stuff you can replace that doesn't bother me. What really bothered me was when in Italy, the next night, they took my French flag, my heritage, they shoved it in a toilet and pissed and shit all over it. I don't know what BS world you live in, but in my world, that's called racial discrimination. That was really hurtful. What I did do was I went to Arn Anderson, who was the agent, and I asked him. Arn's advice to me was don't sell it. I was like, okay. The next person I went to was The Undertaker, and I said, what do you do when someone does this to you? And he goes, well, you find out who does it. He ordered them to do that because I didn't go out drinking with him and the guys at a bar. Since cannabis is federally illegal in the US, WWE's wellness policy does not necessarily allow one to have it in their system, as talent are reportedly given a $2,500 fine. On the Midnight Hustle podcast, the Godfather, Charles Wright, took a moment to talk about Vince and Shane McMahon's views on the drug. What you are failing to realize is that it's a big corporation, and they answer to a lot of people. So if they let people smoke weed, it's not federally legal, and you're still breaking the law no matter if it's legal in state. If it was up to Vince would have everybody smoking. Vince is no fool, but he has people to answer to, and it's a big company. He just can't say it's okay to smoke weed, because what happens if you go to a state where it's not legal? They bring the police in, they test you, and there's a lot of legal things. It ain't because Vince don't want to. The second it becomes legal, Vince would be the first one on that wagon. I mean, Shane owns a cannabis co-op in California, a big co-op. Vince is not against weed. He's a businessman. I'm telling you, I know this 100%. He would much rather see people smoke cannabis than all this other stupid stuff if it was up to him. Believe me, when it comes to Vince McMahon not having an issue with weed he supposedly sparked up in front of former President Donald Trump at a concert, at the end of the day, it will take a change in federal law to allow WWE talent to consume cannabis without any repercussions. Jim Cornette knows a thing or two about managing wrestling talent, as he is best known for his time with the legendary tag team The Midnight Express. On his podcast, he touched on AEW's mishandling of their managers, and almost none of the managers can bump. There's Vicky Guerrero, or Arn Anderson, or Jake Roberts, or it's Tully Blanchard. I mean, Tully is still taking bumps every now and then, but it's not like anybody can get physical and come up. That's the whole point of having a manager, put the heat on them, so that people have to pay to see them get their butt kicked. And I have said that's why I don't do it anymore. What would the payoff be? I'm not gonna take bumps anymore, so nobody could ever beat me up and get even. John Cena was regarded as the franchise player of WWE, as he has made the move to Hollywood and become even more of a mainstream star. On After the Bell, NXT star Odyssey Jones recalled speaking to Cena backstage, asking him what he was thinking. Despite some of the advice going over the NXT star's head, he was able to take home lessons for the future. I'm fortunate. A lot of my dark matches were with Austin Theory. He's a protege. The kid is the truth. He's awesome, and working with him was definitely good for me. I haven't even been working and wrestling for 3 years yet, so for me to go to the back and the feedback is different. There's not a lot of people on the main roster my size who are working my way, so the feedback is a bit different. To hear the mindset and psychology from people like John Cena and Edge and even Rollins, the things they say are huge, even from psychology in the match. I remember being in the back in Gorilla with Cena prior to his first promo back. I was actually in the dark match before, which is insane itself. I asked him what he's thinking, and he instantly looked at the screen and chatted off so much stuff. Some of it went over my head, and maybe I'll get to catch him one day. Some of it got in, and one of the things that seeped in was hearing the crowd chant. Before the show, you heard the crowd chant, "Some Cena sucks, others say let's go Cena," so you started hearing them chant. He instantly started rattling off, "I'm not going to give out all the tricks, because not every day do you get to talk to John Cena." He started rattling off, looked at the screen, instantly popped up, and saw people that I didn't see. I figured my eyes would be younger and fresher than his, but I don't have the eyes that he has for what we're doing. He instantly just went boom, 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 "Look at these kids here, look at this guy there, he's wearing my gear, so I'm going to know." I'm like, oh my god, this is insane. With him said to be a star on WWE's tertiary brand, the advice from Cena will remain etched in his memory. With him suffering a storyline rib injury thanks to Randy Orton, MVP has taken time off to get surgery done on his knee. When it comes to how long he's expected to be out, Meltzer noted on F4W Online that MVP had knee surgery this week, so he'll be out of action for a while. Many fans wanted to see the Hurt Business reunite, especially after Big E won the title from Lashley and mentioned the faction getting back together to take on the New Day. After winning gold at the Tokyo Olympics, Gable Steveson has been signed by WWE. Speaking on the Monday Mailbag, Gerald Briscoe was asked if Steveson has what it takes to be the next Brock Lesnar, with him saying he has what it takes and has a better personality than Lesnar and Kurt Angle. He's got all the attributes and all the skills. I think where he's far ahead of both of these guys at this time right here, he's got a better personality. He's out there. He's a young kid. He likes to have fun. He's a serious guy when it comes to training. Steveson previously stated that he is not the next Kurt Angle. Still with him only being 21 years old, he's got a ton of potential to have a long and fruitful career in WWE. Following his comments regarding Ric Flair sexually assaulting a stewardess on the plane ride from hell, Tommy Dreamer has been removed from Impact Wrestling and is now no longer a part of Busted Open Radio. As Dave LaGreca noted, "Tommy effed up. Tommy effed up on Thursday. As a father of a daughter who will be going out into the world, these are the things we worry about. There is no place for these comments or thought processes. As I said, the comments are indefensible. For the time being, Tommy will be off the show. How long? I don't know." While it seems there is a chance Dreamer could get back on the show, on the other hand, Ric Flair's CarShield commercials have been pulled, with many fans calling for Tony Khan to not allow him in AEW. Sticking with Tommy Dreamer, he took to Instagram to apologize as he wrote, "Regarding my comments on Dark Side of the Ring, it was never my intention to offend, hurt, or victim shame anyone. I understand my comments were insensitive and could trigger emotions in someone's own personal past. I do not condone sexual misconduct of any kind. I apologize to anyone I offended. From the bottom of my heart, I am so sorry." This led to AEW star Chris Jericho commenting, "Forgiven." And this was your Pro Wrestling News Update. I hope you're all having a great day. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you later.